and the entire group has to discuss on the topic. So the thinking time for group discussion is 1 minute and performance time is 10 minutes. So all these 11 participants will be discussing on the topic. Okay? So I request
given to us for the discussion is, should youth enter in politics? Friends, in my opinion, students must be enter in the politics because there is a big need of you. If youth do not enter in the politics, bad people will be go there and they will make us push it. They are Friends, I invite all of you to participate in the discussion.
My name is Fatiha Sheikh. Talking about the topic, should youth be introduced in the politics? Yes, of course, the youth should involve into the politics. Why? Because the youth knows how they want the nation to be developed, how they want their country to be developed. So they have a broader idea of it, and they will execute it. And they take steps to for the betterment of the nation. So they should be introduced into the politics.
Everyone, my name is Divan Ankani, and yes, I think that youth should be definitely enter into politics, because Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam says that youth are the future of the society, they are the future of the country, and they definitely will make a long way in developing new ideas for the
that youth should enter into the politics. If as we all know, diamonds cut the diamond. If the youth are entering into the politics, then they are know what are the main causes of backlog of India or of the respected state or all. If we youth enter into the politics, the technology development will be increasing rapidly. And I think, and I am not saying that the old generation who are in the politics, they are not working on the development. But I think if we enter into the politics, the growth will increase rapidly.
Thank you. I agree to this point that youth should enter into politics, and there should be a kind of blended relationship. That is a combination of experienced people as well as the newcomers. That is, it should be a blended relationship. That is, youth as well as experienced people must enter into politics. So always complaining against the different necessities which are not being provided by the government. What we should do is take an approach in correcting it rather than complaining about it. So the youth have a tendency of complaining over things. Rather, we should take part and be an initiative, take an initiative towards developing those things rather than complaining onto those things which are, which we feel is wrong, which are in the political system.
I would like to second with her. I would say that the awareness regarding the youth entering into politics is less. We should make the youth aware about the social and economic conditions of our country, and so that they should come up, not just discuss about the social cause, but do something for the people of our nation. And that is what is required by our country at this point.
Yes, of course. I personally agree with you people.
Hello everyone, my name is Ajay Pade. Actually there are two sides of corruption. One is good, two sides of politics. One is good and bad. Bad definitely includes corruption. Education also includes corruption. For example, if there is a student with high marks and there is a student with low marks, definitely if the student with low marks you donation to the college, then they have to teach. So the opportunity of the high skilled student goes away. So that's why youth should enter corruption so that we can develop the college.
My good name is Nikita Shetty and I am here to make an effort to give some information about politics. Entering politics is good, but it also has advantages and disadvantages. Some people are badly corrupted. Due to that, your whole environment gets polluted side of things. We also put some money and all for bad things, and the people who are really knowing and who really want to take part in it are left behind just because of this corruption. So we people should put an effort to destroy this corruption and put the goodwills all ahead.
The elders know the experience and youths know the needs. So if both combine and work, it will be a very good for society. And the initiatives taken by our Prime Minister Narendra Modi, like suppose for example digitalizing India. So that thing the youth knows really well. They know more about the advanced technology. They know a lot about technology. They are learning about it. Like suppose for example engineers, they know a hell lot about technology. So we can enhance technology and we can make our India digitalized, which is what our PM Modi wants.
I believe that every coin has two sides, and when we talk about some particular things, it has advantages as well as disadvantages, and internet has proved to be both. For me, I would say internet has been a boon. Digitalization has been taking place in our country. Everywhere, everyone has using smartphones, and smartphones are operated by computers. We use social media for civil state, and they help us to convey information, messages, and get information from all over the world.
Good afternoon
everyone, my name is Sudha Kendra. And I think that the internet has been a boon for mankind. It helps such a vast number of things that we cannot imagine. It has a dark side too, but it's always the best for us. We should use it in a good way or a bad way.
Hello, I am
Yash Agarkar,
and I definitely think the internet is a boon for our current generation.
Because the sharing of information was never been easier than before. Today our world is so connected that we can share any terabyte of information with a click or a snap of finger from one corner of the world to another. Internet has given the students and we can say any aspects of our life or
Hello everyone, my name is Dipali Dodmani. I feel internet is very good for us. As there are three things for people which are needed, air, water and shelter. And nowadays internet is the first needy thing that every human being is needed. Internet is nowadays very much, and people are connected through internet to everyone. We can get information from internet. Because what nowadays people travel everywhere in the country, but they are not knowing the things, historical things in that place. But using internet, they can search and getting the information from the internet historically. They can travel safely through the Google Map.
This is the first time. And I think internet is a boon or curse, depends upon the person, how the person uses internet. If he is a hacker, then the internet becomes curse for him. And if he uses for good purpose, such as developing the nation, making new software, it becomes a boon for him. So I think it totally depends upon a person how he uses internet.
Hello, my name is
Pradeep
Kajat, and here I would like to differ a bit with my friends and would like to say that internet is a sort of a curse for mankind in today's life, because yes, internet has advantages, but many people are using internet for different purposes like hacking accounts, and also it is a sort of a time waster, and people are getting addicted to it and it is affecting all the youth. So I would like to say that internet is a curse in today.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Ajish Bhutkar. Everybody uses internet, but in the name itself, it is a net which can, you know, that every spider gets affected. Every spider makes a net, and all the flies are get stuck in the net. Like that, it personally depends on us how we use the internet, rather than because everybody now. Everyone present here has a smartphone and internet services, but in the internet is our choice to get stuck or make a good use of it. Optimistic use or the negative use, both sides, every coin has two sides. So it personally depends on us where we want to be in the optimistic
side. So everyone has said like internet has advantages and disadvantages, and I agree with that. But I guess nowadays internet has been cursed also, because like hacking and all this like growing very fast, and I guess things like Momo Sardin and all the societies, they are also spreading through internet. So it's kind of a curse. So people are losing their lives, and also in banking also, due to hacking, bank accounts get
leaked. Hello everyone, my name is Anushka Pepperpulkar, and I would like to say that Mark Zuckerberg, who is the founder of Facebook, doesn't use Facebook. He doesn't get so much involved on Facebook as compared to other people. So the one who's spreading the virus doesn't get affected. So I would like to say that it's kind of a curse for everyone. And socialization has been reduced because of it. And family matters have been started. So I would like to say that it's a curse for everyone.
Hello everyone, I'm Kajal Kukar. And according to my point of view, I think internet is a boon. Because we use various technologies, the world has grown various technologies. So, and internet has been made the part of a lifestyle. So, and there are so many advantages of internet, as my friend said. It can be a curse when the one uses it in the wrong way. So, according to me, he's
20% of the person
who is using the internet.
I think positive data, and I agree with you all that, and I would like to say that the first internet was introduced to Navy to communicate for communicating their stuff, and I would like to say that myself, I am people can use internet as communication for communication purpose.
Every Indian citizen should, if the the use of internet in an optimistic manner to develop his or himself oneself's personality and make and progression of our country should be at a maximum rate which is possible, and it will be any work we do from the internet should be useful to each and every citizen of India. That should be every Indian citizen's aim.
When you say internet is a curse, you cannot just rely on one option. You see, the globalization has brought the world closer. When you wanted to send a letter in earlier age, it would take days. But due to internet and email, you can send it in a second. So you just cannot rely on the opinion that the creator is not using. That doesn't mean that people should not use. The creator is using, is not using. That doesn't mean that others should not use. He has created for others to use. So I would say that internet has definitely been a boon for society.
In my conclusion, I would like to say that of course everyone uses internet, but we should know where to draw the line. We should know that what is our limit. Nowadays people are taking those silly challenges very seriously and wasting their time. So rather than that, I would like to say that we should know how much to use so that the internet can be a boon for us.
I have already said that it depends upon the person how he uses internet. And if internet is a pool, then why these people games no more created? So I think it depends upon the person.
As well, the good and bad exist in the world. You just cannot say only good is happening or bad is happening. We are just like that.
Yeah, but it has a bad side too. So we are not saying that only good is the it doesn't have any advantages. But we are telling him like that internet doesn't have any advantages. Yes, we have advantages, but the as you said, words are two sides, so there are also disadvantages, like you said that people are taking
challenges. I don't know that, right, but we should make limited use of internet. There should be time limit for hours.
And I am against of this topic. Because when we try to read silently, so many things comes in our mind. If you try to read loudly, we will be focused only on the words.
I am Saman Joshi and I don't agree with this because if we read silently, it is easy to grasp the point. If we want to grasp anything or learn anything, we can grasp it properly and we can go to the point exactly and deeply.
My name is
Mahalo Guru Jagdala.
Silently is very important to whereas for the other, loud reading is beneficial. It may vary. If a person is very focused, then he reading silently can grasp more power and can memorize the things rather than reading it loud.
My name is Mia Kamurthy. Recently, I read one news that silent reading is not better than loud reading, because when you read loudly, then 80 to 85% are success this year. So silent reading is possible if you think you can read and you achieve more. Then according to this research, I go to that.
Good afternoon everyone, I'm Saili Chavan and I think silent reading is far better than reading aloud, because we are in our own peace, inner peace, and we can focus on what we are reading and simply don't disturb others. Better silently reading and grasp everything.
As she says, silent reading is better. Why it is better? It is better because when we read silently, we go into another world. The another world is when we imagine something in our mind, we go into the another world and we think about it. When we want to understand something, we should read it silently. And we read it loudly. When we read it loudly, what happens is we focus on all of the same. So this happens in every time. So I think silent reading is better.
Hi friends, good morning. My name is Pratik Jain and I think that silent reading is more better and effective than loud reading, because when we are reading silently a topic, then it will not affect our brain, but it will get actually digested into our brain, and we will be more comfortable with silent reading, and we can execute more and many things by reading silently. Loud reading will also disturb the others who are reading besides us, and so I agree with that silent reading.
I would like to agree with all my friends' point of view. Of course, everyone has a different point of view,
But according to me, what I have observed in myself while studying is that when I read loudly, no other thoughts come into my mind. Of course, every one of us have experienced this thing. When we read in silently, a lot many thoughts come into our mind. And then we are unable to decide which thought we should go and which thought we should prioritize. And sometimes it happens that studies is left behind and we think our own self and build our parents.
While we read silently, we go through other thoughts come to our mind. So I think reading loudly is better than reading silently, because reading loudly also brings confidence in us and can clear our subject or topic.
Good morning everyone, I am Rupa Nadkarni. I personally think that loud reading is better than silent reading, because if we are just reading for entertainment like storybooks or news, then we can read it silently. We get it very easily, what is mentioned there. But while studying, we need to read loudly so that we understand the concepts. So I think read loudly is better.
The topic is silent reading is better or not, or loud reading is better or not. I think silent reading is better because it works for me. Because it works for me that a person can focus on things and not coming to mind if a loud is reading. And silent reading is better in other aspects too. Also, it may vary person to person that someone is reading aloud and it is beneficial for that person. So I think silent reading is better for me.
Exactly, I agree with my friend, and I wanted to say that when you go in the library, you cannot read it aloud every time and disturb other people as well. So you have to read it silently, and it will benefit. It is beneficial for you, because when you speak loudly or read loudly, what happens is other will look at you and you may get distracted. Is she judging my words or is she judging my pronunciation? So this happens.
If we are reading silently, then the concepts which are not understood by us, it makes it difficult to think, and we feel very poor, and that may cause to us to make feel asleep. If we are reading in loud, we will know exactly what we have to do and where we are. So that
I agree with my friend, because I want to give my personal example. When I try to read silently, I don't get anything. And then I read loudly, everything will be grasped.
I also agree with this, because when we are reading loudly, the authors are get disturbed, and when we are reading silently, then the concepts and whatever topic we are reading will be easily understandable, and it will be digested fast.
So according to me, the Quora and the all recent studies say that the loud reading is really useful for our mind, and it is proved that loudly laughing is the best or mood. So according to that, go through it and change yourself when you feel silent reading is also good.
According to me, silent reading is better for grasping and learning. But if we want to be an orator or we want to increase our stage daring and exposure, and loud reading is necessary.
Of course, my friends, the reason behind why we read is understanding it, getting knowledge. However we read, however we do the studies, the main aim of every one of us is knowing it or understanding it. However, if we read loudly, no other thoughts come into our mind. If we read silently, no one else will get disturbed. It's up to us, of course. But the main aim that no one should forget is understanding what we are reading. I think so. Thank you.
Also for silent reading, as she said, in library we need to read silently because there is a lot of silence and peace. But in the house it is not possible. Sometimes the cooker whistle noises so loudly. Then family members are speaking. Then television is on. So we need to read loudly and concentrate on it.
So,
if I pick up the 90% people, they are silent readers. Yes or not? Definitely yes. Because silent reading is something like we can concentrate on, not concentrating on other things, only concentrating on the topic we are reading.
Completely agree to you.
silent reading would be really beneficial, as we can concentrate on the topic, analyze it, and we can even argue with ourselves whether the topic is actually giving you something or your mind is diverted anywhere. So better to be at peace, read, analyze and understand the topic, and just, yeah, silent reading is good, I think so.
So this book discussion was subdivided into two parts, that is a positive side and negative side of silent reading. So I want to conclude our group discussion by saying this: every point has two sides. They both are beneficial. It depends on the reader how they want to read it and how they feel they are comfortable in. So that's it for the group discussion. Thank you very much.
Yes, my friend, I would like to agree with every one of you and also every listener sitting here. I would like to conclude saying that, please friends, remember the main aim why we are reading or why we are learning: to get knowledge, isn't it? So while we are getting knowledge, everything is good. Everything is good going. Either you read lovely or you read silently. Please remember the main aim that if you are getting knowledge, you are on a right path. Thank you.
I want to sum up today's topic. The main aim of the reading is to understanding the concept. And according to me, silent reading is better than the ready for that.
Please believe you, because for all instructions, you are very much to the topic for Rupa Nadkarni is, Rupa Nadkarni is, memorable day of my life and the thinking time 1 minute has been up.
Good afternoon, respected judges and all my dear friends. I am Nivan Antani and my topic is the most memorable day of my life. So yes, I would like to start by saying that the most memorable day of my life was when I passed my 10th and my results were being declared. Because that moment of time, I was pretty much scared about what is the result, what I'm going to plan, because the standard 10th is the turning point of the life. It is then you decide which career, which stream are you going to choose. So the day when my results were being announced, I could see myself and my mother being so tense. In fact, my mother was even more anxious and stressful as compared to me. So when the results were declared and I got a good percentage, I saw my mother even getting more happy than myself, and that was the most memorable day of my life, because it was that day when I realized that my mother is even more happy for my success.
Okay, fine.
Good morning to one and all present over here. My topic for today is plastic ban. Plastic ban, one of the most current issues that have taken place, one of the most current events that have been taken place by our Maharashtra government, by Devendra Fadnavis. This initiative has been one of the best initiatives ever taken in our India. Why? Because plastic is harmful for our environment. We are supposed to be taking care of our environment. We should remember one thing, that we are for the earth. Earth does not belong to us. We are supposed to take care of it. We need to preserve the earth for our future generation. If we use plastic is one thing which is non-biodegradable, which causes harm to the earth, and lighting it to fire causes a lot of toxic gases to release, which is harmful for all living beings, plants, animals, human beings, everything. So you're supposed to take care of the environment. If you do not do this, there will be nothing left for the future generation. So plastic ban is one amazing...
Good afternoon, one and all, respected teachers and students. Myself, Pratish Kunekar, and my topic is importance of English. We know language is one of the means to express our words and ideas. It is a way to communicate. English is one of the most useful language to communicate. English is considered as the international language which is useful. English creates a good influence among the listeners. English is the language which creates a good impact among the audience. It creates a good relationship among the people. In today's world, as the competition is increasing day by day, English is considered as one of the important languages. So each one of you must speak in English so that you can compete with the world. English is regarded as an important language, as it helps to you to express your views, ideas and communicate with each other. English, the importance of English is very, very, in today's world the importance of English is too much,
as it helps to express your views. Your turn starts now.
Good afternoon to one and all. I'm Sanjana Sundar and my today's topic is Solapur and its popularity. Solapur city is one of the most developed cities in our Maharashtra. I would say Dadra because I'm being a biased. I live in the city called. When we talk about Solapur city, I feel immense pride because I'm staying in this city and I have been living the city from my childhood. I love this city, not only because it has been given me so much of education. I have been taking my education in this city. Solapur city is famous for the jawar production and its sugar production. It is a very well-known city worldwide. And most of the this city is increasing its popularity due to the term attached to it, smart city. We are developing this. In few years, we could say that this could become a smart city and it could even overpower Pune and Mumbai. It could be. Solapur city is very famous for this too, for the education facilities. There are so many universities in this. There is Solapur University which holds many colleges under its wing.
But I know. A couple of minutes on social impact of social media on our lives. As everyone knows, internet is the net in which everybody, every Indian in fact, almost 90% of the Indians are stuck in the internet. But of that, according to me, only around 10% of the people in 10% of the Indian citizens are using it in a positive way. Rest of the people which is not utilizing it to its best is the youth. We youth should use it to develop our brain and enhance the skills of our brain, because according to the research, only 10% of the people, the great scientists can use their brain only up to the 10%. And if the scientists are using the brain 10% after doing so much of research, then we can at least take the available knowledge provided by the great scientists to develop our brain, because
my name is Anushka Fatehpurkar and my today's topic is my experience of English proficiency test. Today was a great day, a great learning experience. There are the most good English professors over here who could judge me and who could really give me their opinions. I could also compete with so many students and know their views about so many different things. This is a great learning experience for me, and for the first test I could see how much I know actually about this language, as well as the second test taught me that the competition is really, really hard, and there are so many different counterviews as well as views of so many people, and this was a really great experience for me. Thank you.
Her performance time and Shervani Zadav's thinking time has begun.
Honorable dignitaries and my dear friends, good afternoon to one and all present here. Today my topic is my role as a citizen. A very big topic for me, interesting topic for me. As everyone has said, I want to take my nation ahead. I would like to start like, I want to first take my colony ahead, take my area ahead. Then I would take my Solapur ahead. Wherever you are living, just start from there itself. First, talking about our area, which is not very developed, and we talk about nation to develop. When we start to develop our area, our locality, our city, then state, and then we can take ahead our nation together. As a total 29 states, 7
crowd. Also, as our sir earlier mentioned that they expected only 250 students and 350 or more than 350 students participated. Also, they might have become so nervous or anxious about how to manage the more 100 or 150 people at this present moment. I would like to thank you all for your support and such a good and such a proper management of this event. Thank you all.
Good afternoon, everyone. So I would like to share my experience that it was a really good platform to showcase your skills and to test your performance, that is how you stand in front of such a big public. That is, you get to know on a level of understanding your communication skills, how can you improve them, how you can improve your grammatical skills, and just it's a friendly good competition to enhance your skills as well as to test yourself that where you stand in this big world of competition. And it has a very nice event organized by various levels, through grammars, through GDs, extempores. And so yes, I enjoyed a lot taking part in this competition, and thank you.
It was a great competition, and competition is not only about winning, it's about participating, and I'm really glad that other students from other colleges are enthusiastically participating in this, and they are asking your numbers, like what did you got, what was your number, what was your answer, and everyone was so curious about your answers, about the grammar things. So I'm really glad to see everyone so interested in English, and thank you all for organizing this competition, and I'm really happy for this. Thank you. Through programming, I don't know much more about Ms. Which year I am in English. So to guess myself, I'm in here. The coordinators and the coordination is really nice. The guidance very nicely. Thank you so much to all.
Actually, I have participated in this SATI English proficiency test last year also, and I had eliminated in the semi-final, and now I had selected in finals. It had been a great change during 1 year, and I would like to thank this SATI English proficiency test for giving the students like me and you all a platform to improve, develop, and show our talents, that we can do our best in English, and we can develop each and every quality which are required to become a good personality. Thank you. First of all, I would like to thank Sanmaitan College for giving all the students the opportunity to speak and communicate in English. After all, communication is the motive to exchange our views and ideas for each other. So, by sharing this view, I personally got a lot of knowledge today, and how should we communicate with people, how should we communicate people and share our views is a great skill which I am feeling blessed to talk here for a couple of minutes. And our main motive is English. English is the language which is the global communicated language, which you go anywhere in the world, you will get at least a person for speaking, to communicate in English. So, with our future aims, to grow our future aims, not only in India, we should hoist our flag even in the other countries. And for that, the basic thing is to share the knowledge, to share our views. And for that, English is the only medium. So, I request and urge everyone present here to develop their communication skills. And I personally thank Mr. College for giving us such a wonderful opportunity. Thank you.
I'm from A.R. Kurla College. It is not a competition for all of us. It is a good experience for all of us. Congratulations to all the students and better students, all the bachelors. Good afternoon to all. I'm Shraddha Mani from Asia Patel Polytechnic Institute. And I would like to express my wishes, as this arrangement was very nice. As English is a universal language, it can be understood all over the world. The arrangement which was made by the teachers of this college was very nice. I congratulate the speakers who spoke in the discussion. Thank you.
The countdown has begun.
That is the prize distribution ceremony of the Intercollegiate English Proficiency
proficiency test organized by English Department of Sangameshwar College.
In association with Sathi Sun English Speakers Club.
I welcome the chief guest of this prize distribution ceremony, Honorable Secretary Dharmaraj Kanani sir.
I welcome all the participants, faculties in this prize distribution ceremony.
Now, let us have a huge round of applause for all the participants who has taken a lot of effort in all the 3 hours of
Friends, Atithi Devo Bhava is the culture of our nation. According to that, we welcome our today's chief guest, Honorable, respected Dharmaraj Kanani sir. Let me call upon here Professor D.M. Maitri to introduce our today's chief guest. So give big hands for him.
Honorable Secretary Dharmaraj Kanani sir, Principal of the College, Ponga sir, my colleagues, Mahashaya sir, the Chairman of English Literary Association, my senior colleagues in the department, students, participants. Education today needs collaborations, tie-ups, MOUs, that is memorandum of understanding. Every element should be outcome-based, result-oriented. So to make English learning in Solapur and in Sangameshwar College, we decided to collaborate. Since last year, we have been organizing this activity to make English learning different, to give the students the hint about the level of their English. Once you appear for such tests, that can be the part of your curriculum weighting, where you can clearly mention your co-curricular activities, that you are the winner, you are the participant of the district level competition. With this in our mind, we collaborated with Sarthi English Speaker Club, unique in its way. It is the place where students come together every Sunday. They speak English throughout the day and they do a lot of activities. When we came to know this one, we have collaborated our department with their activities. With this in our mind, last year we organized, but we had never imagined that the response will be so much, reaching around 400. So it was a marathon for us, especially Karade sir doing his level best for the last 1.5 months, and the result is here. The only objective was to give you exposure to this type of events where they are part of campuses nowadays. So friends, it was possible because of your interest only. Karade sir will be presenting his brief report about what exactly things happened, but on behalf of my department and English Literary Association and the Sarthi Sundays English Speakers Club, I welcome the dignitaries on the dais. With these words, I conclude my welcome speech. Thank you very much.
या डिपार्टमेंटचे इतर सर्व स्टाफ,
या निमित्ताने या ठिकाणी या स्पर्धा घेण्यासाठी ज्यांनी सहकार्याच्या भूमिकेतनं कॉलेज यूज केलं ते सगळे मॉनिटरी आणि मोठ्या संख्येनं आता सांगितल्याच्या सरांनी उपस्थित महाविद्यालयातून आलेले 2400 पर्यंत स्पर्धक विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो सरांनी परवा सांगितलं पहिल्या वर्षाचा अनुभव सांगितला आणि या वर्षी अशा पद्धतीची बेस्ट या ठिकाणी आपण घेतोय तुम्ही या हे म्हणाल सर मी काही इंग्लिशमध्ये स्पीच देऊ शकणार नाही परंतु त्याला येत होतं की ही जी ऍक्टिव्हिटी आहे ती मी बघाल आणि खरोखरच चांगलं वाटतं या ठिकाणी आल्यानंतर ज्यासाठी मोठ्या सर धडपडतात एक क्लब स्थापन करून इंग्रजी विषयाची भीती मनामधून काढायसाठी प्रयत्न करतात कारण माझं पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएशनच शिक्षण माझं ग्रॅज्युएशनच शिक्षण कर्नाटकातलं झालं तिथे इंग्रजीची एवढी भीती नाही तेवढी महाराष्ट्रातल्या मुलांमध्ये आणि भीती कुठे आणि प्रॅक्टिस कुठे प्रॅक्टिस करत नाही त्यामुळे आपण त्यापासून दुरावलं जातो आणि म्हणून आज या निमित्ताने या ठिकाणी आल्यानंतर आनंद झाला की एवढ्या मोठ्या प्रमाणामध्ये आपण ह्या स्पर्धेमध्ये सहभाग घेतला त्याबद्दल मी ज्यांनी ज्यांनी स्पर्धेमध्ये भाग घेतला त्यांचं मनपूर्वक कौतुक करतो आणि अभिनंदन करतो कारण एक तुम्ही पाऊल टाकलेलं आहे त्याच्यामध्ये पुढचा तुमचा काळ आमच्याकडे गेला पुढच्या काळामध्ये तुम्हाला जगामध्ये कुठं पाहिजे तिथं शिक्षणासाठी सहजासहजी जात आहे आणि त्यासाठी कॉमन भाषा ही इंग्लिश आहे आणि त्याच्यामुळे इंग्लिशचं ज्ञान आणि इंग्लिशच्या माध्यमातून कम्युनिकेशन करणं हे तुम्हाला अतिशय गरजेचं आहे कुठल्याही कंपनीच्या इंटरव्ह्यूला जरी तुम्हाला फेस करायचं असेल तर त्याच्यासही तुमची गरज आहे आणि म्हणून त्या निमित्तानं अशा पद्धतीच्या टेस्ट हे वारंवार झाल्या पाहिजे कॉलेज लेवलला झाल्या पाहिजे इंटर कॉलेज लेवल पाहिजे युनिव्हर्सिटी लेवलला व्हायला पाहिजे म्हणजे आपल्यातील भीती वाढेल कमी होईल आणि त्या माध्यमातून आपल्याला या भाषेचा सराव करणं किंवा भाषेवरती प्रभुत्व मिळवणं आपल्याला सहज तरी शक्य आहे ज्या ठिकाणी त्या ठिकाणी बक्षिस घेतले बन एक नंबर दोन नंबर त्यांचेही मी आपल्या सर्वांच्या वतीनं मनपूर्वक अभिनंदन करतो परंतु इकडं जास्त पण वाटते इकडे आनंद पण वाटतो तिन्ही मुलीच आहे म्हणजे मुलांना चॅलेंज घ्यावंच लागणार आहे तुझं पण घेणार आहे पिक्चर ठीक आहे चांगलं आहे एवढं स्पिरिट ठेवलं तरी बस आहे अभ्यास काही बोलत नाही अशाच पद्धतीनं त्या इंग्लिश डिपार्टमेंटच्या ह्या ऍक्टिव्हिटीज चालत राहो आणि कॉलेजमध्ये एक एन्व्हायरमेंट फक्त इंग्रजी भाषेच नाही बहुभाषीय वातावरण पुढच्या काळामध्ये येत आहे आणि आपल्या देशामध्ये तर ते खूप सोपं आहे माझ्यामध्ये आपल्या सारख्या सगळ्यांना म्हणजे ग्रॅमॅटिकली चांगलं येत आहे किंवा लिहिता वाचता येते का नाही पण बोली भाषेमध्ये आपण दोन तीन भाषा बोलतो एक मदर टंग म्हणून काय तामिळी तेलुगू काय असेल ते बोलतो राष्ट्रभाषा म्हणून हिंदी बोलतो शाळेत शिक्षण झालंय मराठी बोलतो आणि ह्या इंग्रजीचं पण एक भाषा म्हणजे त्या भाषा तर माझ्यामध्ये कमीत कमी प्रत्येकाला येतात पण एवढंच आहे की त्या 4-5 भाषेमध्ये प्रभुत्व मिळवण्यासाठी पुढच्या काळामध्ये आपण जर प्रयत्न केला तर ते जास्त चांगलं होणार आहे आणि आपली एक पर्सनॅलिटी ही बहुभाषेमुळे वेगळ्या पद्धतीचे साहित्य आपल्याला सहजासाठी वाचणं अशा पद्धतीनं होऊ शकतं आणि म्हणून तशा पद्धतीनं आपल्याकडनं पुढच्या काळामध्ये प्रयत्न व्हावे एवढंच करून मला त्या ठिकाणी बोलून या कार्यक्रमामध्ये पाहुणा म्हणून बोलून या ठिकाणी माझ्या हस्ते बक्षीस वितरण केलं
of the department chair, Abhavul, my chairperson.
Honorable Chief Guest, Secretary, Sangmeshwar Institute, Sri Dharmaraji Karate, Sadhi Club Chair, Coordinator, Sri Vangasar, HOD and Vice Principal, Sri Maitri Sir, and the other faculty members of English Department, and students of various colleges. First, I congratulate all the successful winners of this fest. I also congratulate the organizers for such innovative activity. I think it will make the students test their English proficiency in this examination. English is an international language or the language of opportunities. The joint effort of Sangmeshwar College and Sathi Club is successful. I wish this collaboration will continue to raise the level of English in Solapur so that Solapur students will be competent with other metro city students in their career. With these few words, I conclude my presidential remark, and once again I congratulate each and every student who have participated in this exam.
Good afternoon, everybody. Respected dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, Honorable Secretary Sri Karabi Sir, respected Principal Ratnanam Ganga Sir, Vice Principal Mitri Sir, Chairman of English Literary Association Dr. Manchale Sir, my colleagues, Sarthi team and my student friends. I feel proud and privileged to extend oath of thanks on behalf of the Sangmeshwar College and Department of English. On the outside, I warmly thank our Secretary Sir, our all-time inspiration, for spending his valuable time and for being with us for this valedictory function and for giving away the prizes. Thank you, sir. I also thank Principal Ma'am for placing the chair of president of this function. I extend my sincere gratitude towards Manga sir, Karade sir and the team of Sathi for their cooperation in organizing this competition. I also thank all the faculty members of our department for their support. Last but not the least, I thank all the students from various colleges for their participation and making this program a grand success. Thank you one and all.